water transport consists of the affiliated unions from all the major ports in the country. Totally, there are 12 major ports, 6 major ports in the eastern coast, and 6 major ports in the western coast. These major ports are presently governed by the Major Port Trust Act 1963. Now, the government is planning to privatize these major ports in the name of structural change. Earlier, the government wanted to give some amendment in the Major Port Trust Act. Of course, we also agree, we the Major Port Workers Federation, representing the more than 65,000 workers in the major ports, we also agreed that it is to be amended, because in the vicinity of the each and every major ports, some private ports have come. These private ports are not coming under the purview of the TAMP, what is called TAMP, Tariff Authority of Major Ports. That means if any vessel comes to, if any ship comes to the major port, they are charging certain amount which are prescribed in the Major Port Trust Act. Whereas the non-major ports are private ports that has come up very recently near the vicinity of the major ports are not covered under the TAMP, so that they can very well attract the large number of ships and cargoes towards them. So in this scenario, we also wanted to have the change, that is amendment in the Major Port Trust Act. Earlier, the government also constituted a committee, we also contributed what are the changes to be made. But suddenly, during the year of 2015, June, July, by the direction of NITI Ayog, the NITI Ayog has given the direction to the Prime Minister's office that in the pretext of structural change in the major port, the MPT Act, Major Port Trust Act, should be repealed and it should be replaced by the Major Port Authorities Bill. Now, what is the difference between the existing MPT Act and Authorities Bill? Under the MPT Act, no land of the port can be sold to anybody. In the Major Port Authorities Bill, they have changed the act that these lands can be sold to anybody, number one. Number two, these ports are having huge fund with them, surplus funds. Workers' gratuity, workers' pension, and so far the money earned by the port trust, every port more than 1,000, 2,000 crores, the funds are there. These funds have to be deposited in the public sector banks alone, according to the MPT Act. Whereas, in the new authorities bill, the bill says the money can be deposited in any scheduled bank. There is a play between the word scheduled bank and nationalized bank. Nationalized bank means only nationalized bank like Indian Bank, Bank of Baroda, State Bank of India, like that. It is a public sector bank. But scheduled bank means the multinational bank like HDFC, Axis Bank, Yes Bank, like that. There are so many multinational banks are there. So the authorities bill gives the way that this money can be deposited in the scheduled bank. We oppose. And third important point is that the Major Port Trust Act says auditing should be done by the CAG. In the authorities bill say any chartered accountant can come and audit. That means there is ample chances of making the corruption, and some corruption may also be hideout. It can be cheated by the some organization. So that is why we oppose. So now this bill was introduced in the parliament, and finally we have represented a parliamentary standing committee on transport, tourism and culture has taken up the issue. We have deposed before this parliamentary committee, And at last, what we said, the ports are the coastal territory, it is safeguarding the national security and safety. We are mobilizing the people to come to Delhi on November 9, 10 and 11. By that way, we feel that we will at least give some pressure to the government to change their attitude from privatizing the major ports in the country.